Okay, everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's review is on the Resident Evil zombie I have. This review was requested by TheAngrySquad. I do want to say I'm not a Resident Evil fan. I think I only seen like one movie. But I got this for like a dollar or something, and it's good for my Walking Dead displays because I am a Walking Dead fan. So, and TheAngrySquad wanted to see a review on it. So, here you do. Go. Thank you for the request. And remember, anyone can request any other videos or reviews. So, let's get started with the articulation first. He has a swivel on the head, swivel on the shoulders, swivel on the hips, and ball hinge knees. I'm not going to take him off his base because I have him on there really good, and I need him there to stand for the Walking Dead display. So I'm guessing this figure came out around the 90s or something, just because of the articulation and the detail. If you know what year this guy came out, just let me know. First, let's just take a look at, oh my gosh, like, this is a gruesome figure. His rib cage is disposed right there. His bloody shirt. I'm guessing before this guy was a zombie, he was a doctor, because you can see a badge right there, or ID card. On his arm, you can see the skin and the muscles and the ripped shirt. His hand. On his other arm, you can see the exposed bone on his elbow and his fingers. Pretty gruesome. On his pants, not too much details. You can just see, like, mold, I want to say that is, and stuff like that. On his back, you can see his back open. You can see the bones. The bloody shirt, and it looks like you can take this off, and you can actually if you just pull off both arms, and so you can take it off if you like and just have him as a normal zombie instead of the doctor zombie that he is. But just because I you know, don't want to lose it, I'm just going to leave it on. And let's see. You kind of have to put it this way first. And there we go. And there. So, he's pretty cool, you know. I don't have that many zombies for my Walking Dead collection, so he is a good addition. Let's take a look at that face. Pretty gruesome. He looks like he has some maggots on his face. His eye looks like one's up here and one's down there. You can see he's missing a tooth. His hair is nicely detailed. You can see more blood on the coat. It looks like one eye is bigger than the other two. So, that's pretty much it. And there's his shoes. Not much detail on there either. But thank you for the request, TheAngrySquad. And yeah, so that was a review on the Resident Evil zombie. If you guys have any more information about this guy, let me know in the comments. Because I don't know really anything, to be honest, about Resident Evil. Well, that's today's review. Thank you for watching. Remember, you can follow me on Twitter, like my Facebook page, and I do have a fan mail address. And until the next video, have a great day.